trying to live with you and your friends. Whoa. Okay, Wingapa bunnies, it's Michado, and look, this mascara has transferred big time. So you know what? Let's just start, jump right into my monthly favorites. So to fix this problem that I've been having, because my eyelashes are so long and like my mascara is like so wet, so it transfers. And especially when I sweat, girl, in dance class, ooh girl, this is what happens. So how I fix it. Two of my monthly favorites. So this brush, I showed you guys like a long time ago in one of my Urban Decay hauls, and it's the Urban Decay Optical Blurring Brush. So yes, so I take this brush and I take the Lush Light Yellow Color Supplement or Skin Tint, and I just do this. So I like dab it a little bit on the back of my hand and get it on the brush, and oh, the skin's caught up, caught up, trying to live with you and your friends. Whoa, oh my god, it's like magic. And then I usually, so you can still kind of see it, so sometimes I go over it again, and then I put the Emotional Brilliance translucent powder, also from Lush, on top, so it like stays put. But let me just go ahead and do the other eye. Trying to live with you and your friends. Whoa. Trying to live with you and your friends. Whoa. So this brush like really applies it so that it's not like too heavy underneath, because if you put too much, you know, that's what causes creasing. I mean, with like any you know, product, whether it be concealer, foundation, eyeshadow primer, it's the same dealio, so yeah. I'm not gonna put any translucent powder on it right now, because thug life, you know? And whatever. Okay, this makeup is coming off right after this video anyways, because I've had it on all day, but look at, oh my god, I look so cute, huh? Yeah, I do. Okay, so. So, yeah, so these two are my favorite. This supplement, light yellow, as well as the dark yellow supplement. And, yeah, so the Lush color supplements, I really like them, but there's a couple downfalls. Well, really the only downfall that I think there is that Lush can do to improve that product is offer more colors, because they only offer these two colors, two pink supplements. So if you have more of a pink undertone to your skin, it's the light pink supplement and the dark pink supplement. And then they have like, it literally looks like white. And it's the Jackie Oats for like super, super pale people that have a hard time finding like foundation products that match their skin. Try Jackie Oats. The coverage on these is medium. I was expecting it to be like super sheer, but it's actually a medium coverage. So you see, you can still kind of see my freckles, but it's not like you can see every freckle. Like you can see this freckle, you can see that freckle, that freckle, that freckle. Like you can't see all of them, but yeah, so I like these. I really like them, yeah. I just, you know, for the sake of darker skinned people, Lush needs to make more colors for those people. Because these are not going to cover, like, African Americans, it's not going to cover them. So, yeah, that's what I have to say about that. And, so then, continue with more Lush stuff. I have three of the Emotional Brilliance lip products / cheek stains. I honestly would not recommend these for a lip product, really, just because they tend to settle in like the line creases of your lips, so that's why I don't really wear it for that. But I use them for cream blush, so I'm wearing it today. So what I like to do with these is actually mix them. So the one that I'm wearing today is one is like one stroke of this and one stroke of this. So this one is a glamorous one. It's like Nicki Minaj pink. Oh, love it. It's my favorite. And this one is called Charm. So This one by itself doesn't really show up on my skin. I kind of use it as a highlighter. So, but what I've liked to be doing lately is mixing this one with this one, like put like one dab of it on the back of my hand, rub it together, like blend it, and then like, you know, blend it on my skin. So yeah, I like this. And then I also use this one. I mix it with this one, which is Perspective, because I think this one, I feel like, is too dark for my skin on its own. And so if I mix it together, it like lightens it up a little bit, so it looks like better. So yeah, I use these two, and then I use these two. I just really love this one so much. If you use it just plain by itself, it's kind of like really pigmented, so it's going to be like a whole lot of pink. I'm personally into that. If you're not into that, I definitely recommend getting this one and mixing them. But yeah, I really like these. Okay. And I have like tons more colors, so yeah, if you don't like those colors. Okay. More Lush stuff. Bouche de Noël facial cleanser. This is a limited edition cleanser for Christmas, and this came out last year. And I didn't really think this was that amazing of a product last year until I was like trying demoing it on people when I worked at Lush, in case you didn't know that. So I would demo it on people and like put it on their hand, and then we always say like, can you see the difference? And like you literally could see the difference. Like this one has a brightening effect, very similar to the effect that ocean salt has on your hands. So if you guys ever had ocean salt demoed on your hand, you can tell it's like, what? It's like a whole new hand compared to your crusty old dry hand. So it's kind of the same effect, except it's not as like rough as the exfoliation. It's more gentle. It's more moisturizing. And the other thing is this one is basically has a lot. It's basically angels on bare skin, but added with a little bit of cranberries, a little bit of mandarin, and a little bit of, where is it? Oh my god, where is it? Come on, brandy. So yeah, so this is just like angels on bare skin, but amped up a couple notches. So I really like Bouche de Noël, and if you really, really like this product, what you can do is buy like the bigger container and freeze it so it lasts longer, because these cleansers last, they're like good for 3 months. By the time the 3 months come up, I still have a lot of this left. So then I just ended up using it all on my body. So yeah, so anyways, love Bouche de Noël. Loves it. And it's wrapped in seaweed too. So like, that's cool. Okay. And then another favorite that has been a favorite for a few months, but I just forgot to like mention it, is the Godiva solid shampoo from Lush. And this one is really strongly scented like jasmine, and like there's chunks in there, and those chunks are like cocoa butter and shea butter to like really moisturize your scalp and your hair. And I use this when I don't use my purple shampoo, which is Daddy-O. And I really like this one, actually. I like the way that makes my hair feel. I like the way that it smells. But yeah, and people, if you guys have, you know, been following other Lush YouTubes or whatever, you guys know there's a whole new crop of shampoo bars coming out in January, I think. If you're in the UK, they're already out, but in the US, they're going to come out next month. Yeah, next month. And there's a rose jam scented one. Bae. There's a honey I wash the kids scented one. There's a twilight scented one. Like, are you serious? Those three are like my favorite scents at Lush. So I'm just like, freaking out. So excited. Okay, anyways. two more products from Lush. This one is Hot Toddy. It's the shower gel limited edition for Christmas, and you can see all the glitter has settled right there. But people, when you first smell it, when you just smell the pure shower gel like this, you get a punch of all the spices that are in here. Cinnamon, clove, nutmeg. You just think, oh my god, this is like a warm, cozy fireplace. But when I put it on myself in the shower, It smelled like Coca-Cola. And I was like, freaking out. I love Coke. Like, you guys don't even know. I love the soda Coke, okay? Like, I always joke around. Like, my sense of humor is that I joke around about that I do drugs and, like, drink and all this bad stuff. But, like, really, I don't do any of it, like, at all. So I always joke around that I'm, like, a drug addict sometimes. I don't know. If you don't, that's not your sense of humor, you wouldn't get it. But anyways, I'm like, oh my God, yeah, I'm a crackhead. Yeah, I always do coke. I'm a cokehead. Yeah, I always do coke. Yeah. But I'm really talking about the soda, like, because I love the soda. Anyways, so yeah, I just really love hot toddy. And I definitely want to buy the huge container of it because I don't even care. Like, because once it's on you, it smells like Coca-Cola. So I think that's a good scent for year-round because I'm always down for Coca-Cola. Seriously, like, people, if you're at a party and you don't drink, and, like, usually parties are, like, late at night, okay, this is a little tip, straight-edge tip, if, you know, you're not about that drinking life or anything like that. Just, like, make sure, like, usually at parties they have, like, Coke, you know, because they do that Coke and rum, whatever that is, that drink. Okay, so usually they have, like, Coke, but if they don't, like, just bring your own can of Coke. Like, who cares? I do that all the time. Sometimes people, okay, there was a New Year's party or, like, some kind of party that I went to, and I literally brought a Starbucks because it was, like, late at night, and I was tired, and I never drink, so I was drinking my Starbucks all night. Pro tip! Just kidding. What kind of pro? Straight edge pro tip. Okay. And the other shower gel that I love is So White. People, this literally smells like you just are slicing an apple. Like a good apple, though, because sometimes apples are nasty. But it smells so good. And this one has a little bit of silver snowflake luster, they call it. Silver glitter. And it's just a really good scent if you're, like, trying to wake yourself up in the morning. Super refreshing. I just love it. I love So White. This is another one that I'm going to get a big container of. And also there's a So White bath bomb, you know, you feel? And yeah, so you can get that too if you want, but I just like the shower gel more. Okay, I talk so much. Okay, so the last three items are like makeup products. So this 24-hour pencil eyeliner perversion from Urban Decay. People, I talk about these eyeliners all the time. They're literally the best eyeliners you can ever find. Like, seriously. Like, you don't even have to put that much pressure on it to get it opaque. And I like doing this, like, on my tight line right here. I just go brrrr. And people, you see this? It looks like my eyeliner goes all the way in. But pro tip, you just line your tight line right here underneath your eyelashes to the inside. And, like, my liquid eyeliner stops right here. But it looks like it's all the way in because of this. So if you have trouble, like, getting your liquid eyeliner really thin right there, just do, like, with a eyeliner right here on your waterline or your tight line. Oh, my God. Your tight line. And then also I do this when I don't want to, like, wear eyeliner, but I still want my eyelashes to look full. Because, really, that's, like, the whole point of eyeliner is to make your eyelashes look more full. So, and I'm all about my eyelashes, you know? So I just like tight line right here, and then it gives it a dark base. So it kind of looks like you have eyeliner, but like you don't really, you don't draw on the top, you draw on the, it's a whole thing. Anyways, that's a pro tip. Anyways, and then the, my liquid liner is the perversion 24/7 liquid eyeliner. I love this. It's just like foolproof. Like so many times with other eyeliners, like I always mess up on the wing. Like it's always too thick. It's always like whatever, not perfect. But like this, I can get it so precise. It's just like a thin little thing and it's just like so easy to use. I just think this is so easy to use. And it's super black, and that's what I like about if I'm going to wear a black eyeliner, I want it to be blackest black, and this is like blackest black. So yes, what I'm wearing today. Okay. And then my final thing is the Venus Lime Crème palette. Oh my God, I'm even wearing it today. I'm wearing the more like boring kind of colors today. I'm wearing Divine, which is this one, and a little bit of Icon in the crease. So you can see it's like really blended. And then on the lid, I'm wearing Aura. So yeah, that's all. And then I just use like a matte white under eye highlight from another palette that I have. But yeah, you can do so many looks with this palette. I personally love it. If you love to take risks with makeup and you kind of like want to do like neutral colors, but like not boring basic neutral colors, which every other makeup company has, and basically they're all the same, to be honest, people. They're literally all the same, okay? Like, I'm just telling you right now, they're like all the same. But this one is different, so that's why I really like it, because it's different, and I always get compliments on my eyeshadow. Like, you really think someone's gonna compliment you, like, on your Naked palette eyeshadow? It doesn't really stand out that much, because everyone wears it, because it's basic. But, like, I always get compliments when I wear this palette, so. I'm just saying. I'm different. Yeah, I'm different. I'm different. Yeah, I'm different. Okay, so that's basically it, people. That's one of my favorites this month. Anyways, thanks for watching. Peace, bunnies.